Ladies and gentlemen, rock and roll.
Tear down this wall.
All the band is out on the field. He's going to go into the end zone.
And what you gonna do with Hulkamania?
Say no to drugs.
Eat my shorts.
Gentlemen, boys and girls, and children of all ages, hello and welcome to episode 29, 29 of the Bastards of Babylon podcast.
Yeah,
29 Longhorn. I think that is the number of things that we have found out now that they were wrong about on the entire COVID fucking spectrum. I think we're up to about 29. At this point, and all those people that got called conspiracy theorists, or whatever they call them, theorist.
Racist, sexist, homophobe, transphobe, Nazi Hitlers, that's usually the go-to.
Yeah, all that shit, vax deniers, COVID deniers, yada, 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 fucking yada. All the people, all the fucking celebrities, like Howard Stern, that said, you know what? If you don't take the vaccine, fuck your freedom. Arnold Schwarzenegger, fuck you. Fuck your freedom.
Yeah.
It's about everybody.
He's a big German bastard. Austrian? German? Austrian. Who gives a fuck? It doesn't matter.
I mean, list goes on and on and on. I mean, even here into locally, you know, the guys that jumped over and started the freak, they were fucking vax shaming people left and fucking right for not
who
fucking.
Who are they? Let's name them.
Oh, no, that'd be
name them by name. Ben, I mean, let's
Skin, KT,
make them famous.
Kavanaugh.
Where are they at? I'm sure they did a show today saying, sorry, guys, I apologize for being a huge cunt all those months, but my bad. But
to be fair. To them, they might well have done that show. However, I don't know, and I don't think anybody else knows either, because their ratings are literally like the bottom four stations in all of DFW in all formats. They're like right there with, you know, fucking the classical music channel, actually below them, actually. Like, they are way, way down in the shithole. And, you know, Mike Reiner, God rest his soul, has joined up over there now, and I don't think even the old Gray Wolf can save that shit pile of fucking turned woke liberal douches.
Well, if he wants to revive that shitty station, then he can bring in the Revolution Network, maybe the Bastards of Babylon. I don't know. I don't know if we have enough time, but we'll give him an interview. We'll sit at the table, see what he's got to offer. Because nobody wants to hear bullshit, and those days of spewing your bullshit and getting away with it, those are over. There's too many alternative media sources. The news spreads through back channels, through podcasts, through all the, you know, podcasts. It's just, you can't hide the truth anymore. So yeah, I'm glad. I hope this is the end of people like that, but we know it won't be. Rachel Maddow, all those cunts on MSNBC and CNN, that they're not going to answer this. Dr. Fauci, he's not going to answer for it. They'll just carry on business as usual.
Speaking of Fauci, it also came out this week. Like, it's been a really landslide week against all those fucking people, which I hate to see it. When I say hate, I mean love.
I really hate to see all that. That sucks.
It came out that, you know, it was Moderna. No, Pfizer. I want to get it right. I think it was Moderna. They paid Fauci's, the company that he led or whatever, for the production of the vaccine, $400 million this week. So if you wonder, boys and girls, why fucking Mr. Science was so fucking pro the vaccine and, or I'm not calling it a vaccine, pro the fucking shot. It didn't vaccinate you from shit.
Fauci, ouchie.
And then, you know, they poo-pooed ivermectin and all these cheap-ass, like, $2, $3 prescriptions that would literally just knock the shit out in 48 hours. You'd be right back on your feet doing your fucking thing. And it was going to keep spreading no matter what. And now even our own fucking health organizations came out and said, yeah, fucking natural immunity, better than this fucking shot. Who fucking knew? Who fucking knew? Oh, that's right. Fauci fucking knew, because in an interview like back in the 90s when they were asking about fucking just a regular ass flu, he was like, yeah, well, if they do in fact have the flu, then they don't know. They don't need to go get any kind of shot or medication. Natural immunity is much better than any medication that we've ever come with in the history of mankind. That's just, the human body is so resilient. It's the best medicine we could possibly ever have. So he didn't know it. He didn't
know. It's resilient until you pump it full of AIDS that, and then lie about it, which he also did in the 80s. Well, he didn't lie about the AIDS. He just lied about that you got to be careful because you can, it can be transmitted not only through sex, but through, you know, particles and touch. And yeah, if you really want to look it up, the history of Dr. Fauci, he's not the saint that everybody's made him out to be. I'm sure he's a very smart man, definitely smart at making money and lying to people on top of lies and collecting funds from the government and the taxpayers.
Well, I mean, if you look back at the Dallas Buyers Club, whatever that movie, it shows you right then and there, same situation. They're pushing a bullshit medication that never fucking worked. They just made a bunch of money off the government. And this dude, this random fucking...
Oh, yeah.
He'd have been canceled on every fucking social media, everything. Mm-hmm. He fucking went to Mexico, got all this... not natural remedy, but just alternative medicine stuff that was just regular ass shit that actually worked at staving off, you know, death for these people for as long as it could. And this other thing is literally just fucking killing them.
Yeah. And at the beginning of this pandemic, some of the scientists that work in the NIS, and I don't know at what point of the ladder under Fauci, but they were in contact with him saying, hey, this kind of looks like it's man-made. It's showing all these signs of what a man-made virus would do. And of course, Dr. Fauci got in touch with them, shut that shit down. 2 days later, that shit was done. And then they magically, some of these scientists who came out questioning, not even really questioning, but like saying, hey, this looks man-made in private emails with Fauci. Those guys got $1 million, what do they call it? Funding for fund research funding to whatever they were doing. You know, it's
hush
just
money.
Yeah, hush money. It's so gross, but that's fine. Like shit like that's happened forever. The gross part are these fucking media companies, the radio station people, people that should know better, people that should be asking questions, being curious, because that's what you're supposed to do. And finding out the real truth. I mean, we have a pandemic of accepting whatever the fuck the government says in this country. And the media are the most infected. Like whatever they say, rubber stamp it, put it out there. It's good to go. Zero questions. And just everybody, how dare you question it? Why would the government ever steer you wrong? They don't do that.
Oh, yeah. It's been such a bad week for them. Yeah. So the FBI has now came out with their report. Saying, yeah, more likely than not, it did come from the lab in Wuhan. So that was bad for him. And then you remember how Trump got called racist because he called it the Wuhan virus, the Wuhan flu, the China flu. They said, oh, you're
calling it the, well, listen, I call it the China flu because it comes from China.
Yeah, they accused him as, you know, being a xenophobe and trying to, oh, spread hate and all this stuff. Well, I literally listened to a montage today of about 30 seconds of every single news outlet, MSNBC, CNN, ABC, NBC. Every single report started, the Wuhan, China coronavirus, the Wuhan, China coronavirus. Today, reporting on the Wuhan, China coronavirus. They're all calling it that shit now. All of them.
It's amazing. It's an amazing trick that they pull, but...
God. And then, of course, Woody Harrelson, whew, he toasted their ass.
He did it in a liberal Hollywood way, but yeah, they never would have done it before. So I listen to the whole, anytime these monologues come out on Saturday Night Live, I always listen. I find the whole monologue instead of
the whole thing too.
Yeah, I listen to the whole thing. He softened it up and but
my favorite part though was the fact that he said it and the audience, there was no laughter. Did you notice that?
Until he gave the punchline about smoking weed.
Yeah, I do drugs every day. Right, you know, right. What kind of movie is that? And then they laughed, but at first they were like, oh, like they're all clutching their fucking pearls.
Well, these are the dumbasses that still believe all that bullshit that MSNBC is. And I wonder what's been the spin or the story on MSNBC and CNN. What are they just like reporting it like they never said anything else in the past?
Well, first they got mad. They all came. Woody Harrelson goes to Saturday Night Live and spreads crazy conspiracy theories. Like every headline from every Washington Post, every newspaper.
No, I'm talking about the virus being.
Like business. I mean, of course we knew the whole time. It was, business as usual.
These people have no so the conspiracy theories that they pushed for years about Trump getting peed on and Russia owns his ass completely debunked. They never found anything, and they still hold on to that. But then the ones that they make up are the ones that are that they say that we're running conspiracy theories. Like that's just made up. I mean, they all come true. We're running out of conspiracy theories. They all come true. It's like, it's frustrating. These people.
Yeah, I saw a pretty good meme today. It's like something like hard hats will protect you from falling objects. Tinfoil hats will protect you from myocarditis.
Myocarditis?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that'll be the next one that in a year when the data gets too much and we have, you watch, here first, there's going to be an athlete, super, NBA, MLB, or NFL, he will collapse and die on the field or court. It's going to happen. And then just like this, it's going to be like, of course there's side effects. We've been saying it. Like, why haven't y'all been listening to us? It's going to happen.
I saw something on, I don't know if you know who Chelsea Handler is.
She's a big cunt.
Big cunt.
Big cunt.
So that stupid cunt took the second booster, something. And then she went on social media after that and was like, she could tell she was actually scared. She was like, I can't hear out of one side, out of one ear. I'm not feeling very well. And then like 3 or 4 months later, she was hospitalized. The person, one of her writers for her show, was literally on stage doing a fucking stand-up at an improv in Arizona and literally passed out cold in the middle of her fucking improv and fractured her skull. She fell so hard on the stage.
So
and both these ladies are like, Chelsea's in her early 50s. I think this other lady's like mid to late 40s. So like right in the fucking range in which, this shit is affecting people the most. The demographic that didn't need to take the fucking shot once again.
So I wonder how this is going to affect the shot going forward.
They're still advertising their own fucking. I saw an ad tonight. I was like, how?
They're not going to pull the ads. It's not going to happen like that. But, I just wonder, is there going to be still the great divide between, the same people that are saying, it's still better than natural immunity and the new strains.
It's already been fucking debunked. It's already been debunked.
Okay, they don't care though. If they can still sell the product, they're still going to push it. Now you've got the other, people that hear the other information from alternative news sources that are still going to be like, nah, it doesn't do anything. It's not helping you, and it's actually starting to show that it hurts you more than it helps you. So I think it's just going to be business as usual. Continue pushing that fucking product, just like Woody Harrelson said. Just keep on taking the cartel's drugs. And I don't know. If you die, you die.
Well, and the thing is, there's going to be lawsuits. But
no, there won't be lawsuits. They've got the protection from the. They're under this. Remember, this is what James Rogowski talked to us about. That shot, vaccine, whatever you want to call it, is under the same vaccination protection law as the other ones, you cannot sue. At least as of now, we'll see what happens going forward. But it's you don't have you know, suing protection against the government.
But there's always some sort of loopholes and that kind of shit, especially if you can go after a medical organization. But either way, it doesn't matter. Even if they do, you know, they've got all this money stacked back from when the lawsuits start hitting. If they do, and if they do, they'll just fucking drag that shit out in court and basically earn interest on all the money that they've been saving up. So at the end of the day, they'll pay out the fucking interest that they get from our fucking banking system, and it won't cost them a goddamn dime, and they'll also just be rich as fuck. It's just fucking crazy.
Look, I'll say it again, said it before. If you're terminally ill of cancer or something, or maybe you're like 90 and you're on your way out, and I'm not saying do it, but I'm just saying if you get a wild hair up your ass and you feel like being a serial killer, I don't know. Maybe go find some of these evil big pharma people. Maybe go find Dr. Fauci's address. I'm not saying to do it. I'm just saying, like, if there were serial killers killing evil, bad people, maybe we could just turn the other cheek. Just look the other way.
Maybe we can send them to St. Louis. Did you see that video? Holy fuck.
St. Louis was, I don't have this in the current events list. What is this?
So it was yesterday that it happened. And the video, when I saw it, I was like, this is fake. There's no way this is real. This is made up fucking propaganda just to try to make Democrats look bad, which, you know, we call it like we see it. If it's fake on either side, I don't give a shit. It's fake. I was like, it's fake. It's no way this is real. It's way too nonchalant. And then I dug into it, and yeah, it really did happen. I read the police report, saw the fucking local authorities interviewed, and then today they got the guy arrested, and they've officially charged him. So I don't know who this asshole was filming this, but hopefully they called the cops before they started filming, and if they didn't, fuck these people. But this is in downtown St. Louis. It's 10 a.m. in the morning. Broad daylight. There's apparently, before you see the video, a homeless guy and this other guy get into a scuffle across the street. Then they're on their side, these people said, so they're in a restaurant or whatever filming. And the homeless guy is sitting on the pavement, just sitting there. And the guy, the way I thought it was fake was because the guy pulls his gun out and he's like, he can't get the fucking round unchambered, the single round, it's jammed or something. He fucks with it for like a good 20 seconds. Finally gets it chambered, pulls his fucking clip out, puts it in. The guy's still just sitting there. I'm like, what is fucking happening? And the guy walks up to the guy, and the homeless guy just like puts his hand, didn't even look at us, but it's like, come on, man. Like, and you can't hear audio, but like kind of gesture, like, come on, dude, I'm done or whatever. And he literally just, boom, executes this motherfucker on the sidewalk at 10 a.m. in the middle of downtown.
They showed video of this?
Yeah, there's video of it. But what I really thought was fake is as he pulls the trigger, the guy, like, the camera drops and he's like, holy fuck, he just killed him. He just fucking killed him. And then the camera cuts off. And I'm like, nah, that didn't, like, looks totally fake, looked totally set up. And like I said, until I dug out and found the details, no, that shit literally fucking happened.
I mean, actually, I think that's a normal reaction. If you're filming something like that, you're like, what the fuck? Did that just happen? He just killed him? Just execution style? Were these two bums or one bum? And who was the other guy?
One bum and one. I don't know if the guy, they said he might be homeless in the initial report, and the arrest sheet or whatever didn't say. Just said what they charged him with.
This was St. Louis?
Yes, St. Louis.
Is this close to Kansas City where the draft is?
I don't know my geography of Missouri too well.
You think we can go find this guy and talk to him and see, like?
I think he's going to be preoccupied.
Maybe do a little man on the street.
I don't want to do a man on the street quiz with this guy.
Like, sir, last time you were filmed on the street, you murdered somebody. How do you feel today? Tell the good people about murder and about who you think the Cowboys are going to draft.
And then as he fucking he pulls his gun out and starts fucking with it, and we're just standing there filming, like, are you going to give us an answer, or are you going to shoot us in the face?
So you're saying Cowboys, shoot them up. Who? Oh, we're taking Protecting the Texas Tech guy. I got him. Guns up. That's what he's doing. He just doesn't like to talk a lot. I get it.
Oh, it was one of the wildest things I've ever. And again, it was so wild and so nonchalant. That's why I was like, this. There's no way that this is fucking real. It's just not
possible. Well, as bad as the streets of St. Louis are, I hear there's some things going on in Chicago.
Chicago. Those Bears there, they've had enough of Lori Lightfoot.
What's the big dick mayor up to? What's she doing?
So the chick with the biggest dick in Chicago has officially been voted out of her mayoral office. She only got 16% of the vote.
Oh, so it's just a regular election time?
No, I don't know. I don't know if it's a recall or whatever, but the two guys that are leading it are now going to have a runoff election in April.
16%?
16, yeah, I don't know who those 16% are, but
have they seen her dick? I mean, you got to get more than 16% when you got the biggest D in Chicago. Come on.
You know, everybody's like rejoicing or whatever. Like, I see everybody on Twitter like rejoicing. People in Chicago finally bought up. Oh, yeah, God. Dude, but you're just going to vote another Democrat in. It's not like you're going to vote a Republican in.
You talk about, you see, California is a disgustingly liberal, grossly run state. But it's fucking beautiful. It's one of the heaven on earth.
It's not all liberal, though.
Right. Well,
the majority of the state is actually Republican.
Neither is Illinois. Illinois is the same way, too.
Yeah.
Illinois, it's the same. But it's California. It's got fucking mountains and beaches and fucking...
Oh, yeah.
It's beautiful. So Illinois, when I think of Illinois, and even New York, when I think of New York, California, all these... Michigan, all these stupid liberal states. I'm like, okay, we can say that. You know, it's these are beautiful places, a lot of history or whatnot. And we can say that. When I think of Illinois, I just get I don't know. If you could pick one place to have a sinkhole in this country, then it just kind of, the whole state just kind of sinks away. I know Chicago's a great town. We've been there, obviously. Love the town. A lot of history. All that stuff's real good. But like the fucking, they've gone so liberal retarded that they cannot help themselves. The school district you saw, actually I posted that the other day. None of the kids can read and do math at grade level. None of them. They're failing and they pay them up, and the price per student in that state is astro-fucking-nomical. They're paying more per student than almost anywhere else in the country and getting the worst results. And that's just the education and the whole thing, the whole gamut of the government control over there. It's run. I mean, it's always been a corrupt state since like the beginning of the union. It's just always been a corrupt state, and Chicago's always been a corrupt city. But I mean, I would say it's a little bit out of control. But this is the city that had the fucking, you know, the mob and the prohibition and all that. So I mean, it's kind of always been this way, I guess. But
yeah, that was Al Capone's town,
right? So I don't. Maybe it's just their DNA. Their DNA is corruption. Is
good running game and a great fucking defense, baby.
I
that
guess
is
so,
what
man.
They do.
I guess so. So she's out. She can't win. She's artist. So I'm sure it's racist, sexist, homophobic, transphobic, Nazi Hitler syndrome.
I mean, how could it not be?
Yeah, it's stupid white people.
I think it's like two Hispanic guys that might beat her out or whatever, but yeah, of course.
Oh, well, they're probably those, you know, stupid white Mexicans. I mean, they're the worst.
Dirty Italians that she got so pissed off about on Columbus Day.
Oh, you fucking wops. You fucking wops.
Yeah, they're doing like a, what's her name? That's Nikki Taylor, that the Republican lady that threw her name in the hat. Nikki Haley. Yeah, they're probably doing like her. I heard a guy on CNN or whatever that said that she is using her brown skin to perpetuate white supremacy.
Nikki Haley is?
Yeah.
I saw they were giving Nikki Haley shit about because she is technically like comes from immigrants, and I think as she, what is her, let me look it up.
She's,
I don't want
Middle Eastern,
is it Middle, yeah, that's right, yeah, it's some sort of Middle Eastern mix or whatever. But when she first came to enroll in whatever it was that she was enrolling in, whether it was a government agency or a school, I don't remember the story, the only options were white or black. So she put white. Okay, so they're giving her shit because, oh, Nikki Haley claimed white back then, but now she's trying to claim, you know, POC, person of color. It's just like, I mean, people, just, you're so pathetic. Like, it's not the same.
We have so many more options now. I mean, there's so many more options on those forms. You know,
Can't wait till they start putting gender options on the these applications.
Oh, like, they have. Andrew Bogut posted today on Twitter. Remember Andrew Bogut, the big Australian, like 70?
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Poor guy, NBA.
Yeah.
They're signing their 6-year-old up for soccer. And on these form for the youth soccer, it had gender listed, and it was male, female, non-binary, partisan, whatever. All these like 5 or 6 different choices for the youth soccer gender.
Why do they hate people on the spectrum, gender spectrum? Because there's like 892, or is it 8,000? I don't.
That was the most of the smart ass comments.
Yeah, like
you're,
why are they
excluding all these fucking groups?
I know.
Fucking bigots.
And counting the genders are counting. My favorite one until I hear one that replaces it. I'm sure I will eventually. My still favorite one is cake gender. Very soft, very fluffy, very very long. It's so funny because these people are so mentally retarded. Like they don't. They're just describing their personality and calling it a fucking gender. Like, well, you know, I sometimes like to have sex with the opposite sex. And you know, sometimes I don't like the sex at all. So let me create a fucking made up, just make-believe gender that falls into some category that I happen to feel like right at this moment that might change, I don't know, tomorrow. They're so...
Was that you that posted that story about the... genderless dragon or whatever?
Yes. What gender was that? What'd they call it? I do remember, but
I think it was a gender neutral dragon or something like that.
And who was it? I can't remember who it was.
Some random guy, and it was, the post was
like, oh, it was only guy that was all tatted up and like
tongue like
twirling, yeah.
And then it's like, my son won't even have anything to
right,
do
right.
with me. It was the genderless dragon or whatever the fuck. Like,
yeah,
he's good on your son.
Yeah. Yeah, no shit. I mean, you look like a freak show, and that's not a gender. You ruined your face and your body with this, and if you want to, then fine. Like, I mean,
yeah,
knock
your
yourself
choice.
Out. I mean, we can. There's a deeper conversation to be had on whether or not that's, you know, good or bad for you directly. But you do have that right to do that. But don't do interviews being like, oh, poor me. My son doesn't like to blah, blah, blah. I can't get a job, or people stare at me. Like, no shit, people stare at you. Is that's liberals, or I don't even say liberals. How do we categorize? We need a new category for, I mean, woke, like wokest, just call them wokest, whatever. Wokists.
I don't know. It's, what did Bo Burnham describe as that? Because he had that in one of his song lyrics, is the neo fat. Neo-fascist radicals, he said, something like that, are destroying the left. Neo-fascist liberals, something like that, are destroying the left. Basically, like, extreme as extreme can get. Which is funny, because I saw, like, after the Woody Harrelson thing happened, people were posting an interview he did, just a sit-down, like, it was Bill Maher's podcast. So on his podcast, he, like, just sits across from somebody, kind of like we do, in a chair, they have a fucking scotch or whatever, whatever they're drinking. And they just sit there and fucking, you know, smoke a cigar, or joint, whatever, and have a conversation. So, of course, they're both a little toasted or whatever. But they were having that exact conversation that Woody Harrelson said on the thing. He was like, I don't know how we ever got to this point. Like, how did we ever just say this is the only way to do it? And all these other medicines out there, and everybody just gets shut down. And this is like 2 years ago.
Who was it that was on with Mar?
Woody Harrelson.
Oh, okay.
And he was saying this, and one of them, I can't remember which one, but one of them said, see, this is what being a liberal used to be about. Not just accepting everything the government said and finding a different way to do it, or at least asking questions, questioning authority. That was what a libertarian came from. Like, being a liberal was, I'm not going to fucking just go along and punch the company clock and fucking walk the company line. I'm going to ask a few fucking questions. And that is... which I very much put myself in that category of being that kind of liberal. I'm not just going to take your fucking word for it. Like, I don't trust you at all.
That's why I don't do Democrat Republican labels. That's why you'll if you do hear me call myself that, it's probably a slip up. But I usually, and if I do, sometimes I usually correct myself and say that's the way I vote. Obviously, because we have a two-party system, but it. To my core, I just believe in the, you know, in the Constitution. So I'm a Constitution conservative, because that really, you know, you can't flip with that. But like, labels of political parties, they, just like you're talking about, in our lifetime, we've seen the switch. Now, and then, there was the switch before with the Southern, the Dixie Democrats. Like, these things, they switch and they change. But the core, to the core of, you know, a constitution, that doesn't really switch. So I try to stick to that as far as the labels go. But liberals, in the old school liberal and the new quote unquote Republican Party, a lot in common, a ton in common. That's the ironic thing,
which I got pushed back before on our YouTube page, like, oh, imagine conservatives dumb enough to use Rage Against the Machine as their intro, not understanding what that means. I was like, imagine being dumb enough to realize that the people that Rage are singing about in that song are now the fucking liberals, you idiot. Because they're the fucking authoritarian. They're the fucking do what we say, or you're a fucking fascist, you're a fucking Nazi, you're a fucking racist. If you don't just come along, you're part of the problem, not part of the solution. Like, literally, in, like you said in our last time, Rage went against from raging against, you know, the government as it was, to literally now, you would, if they were singing that song for real, they would be singing against fucking Biden and singing against fucking...
they wouldn't dare do that.
No, they don't do it. But I'm saying, if they were being honest about it, if they were being honest about it, that is who the fucking authoritarian party is at this point. Like, there's no getting around that.
Yeah, so like when I talk about the idiots, I don't want to use necessarily liberals. I don't really usually like to use Democrats, so I'll just call them wokest in the for this conversation. That they like to play that trick a lot. It's the, you know, either fuck, you know, put shit all in your face, whether it's piercings or tattoo face tattoos, neck tattoos, do crazy shit with your hair, say crazy shit, whatever the case might be. Everybody look at me, I'm doing special shit, I'm special, I'm unique, I'm a gifted person, I'm different, I'm not like all you. And then when you notice it, and you might like look a little long or be like, why did you do that? They're like, how dare you look at me, I didn't ask for this attention, what is wrong with you, you racist, sexist, Nazi, Hitler, transphobe, homophobe, get away from me.
I have a question. It's for you, and then obviously for the general audience, if you guys want to write in and weigh in on it. Something I've noticed recently, why are all these fucking liberal chicks, modern liberal chicks, why are they all so goddamn angry and ugly? Not one good looking one.
Teach.
Yep. I got it. You in the back.
Me, fat guy. Over here. So my theory is that we are, and I think I brought this up before, I think we're the evolution process has flipped and we're de-evolving. So like, we've gone from, and it's probably a natural thing that goes back and forth, through the history of humans, but like, it goes from like the clean and proper, and then it went to grunge. And then, and it turned, I think, with grunge, I would guess, maybe turned to like the more sloppy, and I just, I don't give a shit. look.
Yeah, it went from, if you want to use that, it went from like in the 80s, you had to have your hair big with hairspray, you had to wear makeup, flashy fucking suits, like chest open, like all like leather with like, you know, your abs and stuff. Like, went from all the prim and proper to
fucking, grunge.
Yeah, torn blue jeans and fucking wearing flannel and splitting clothes.
And remember in the 80s, tattoos were rare.
Oh,
people had them, but if so, like
those are for like bikers and like prison chicks.
So piercings were certainly unusual, especially face and like.
Well, just, no, in the '80s, the big earring in the left if you were straight, and in the right if you were gay.
Yeah, I'm talking about the multiple.
No. You get one big earring, like one dangly earring on either side if you're a dude.
Right. So my theory is that we are de-evolving, just a deconstructionist type attitude, because that's what they believe in. They believe in deconstruction, just, you know, away from structure, away from tradition and stuff like that. Two, and the only way you get away from that from ideology is the shit that they spew. The way you get away from that with your image is you dye your hair weird, you pierce yourself weird, you tattoo to yourself, and if you go back and you look at tribal societies, like, I mean, go to the jungle, think of the jungle or whatever,
the Aztecs, the Incas, what do they have?
They're painted up, they're all like weird, you know, piercings and tattoos and weird shit going on and weird hairdos. We're de-evolving.
Yeah, you bring that up, and I hear what you're saying. But the funny thing is about those are bad examples to bring up. I'm actually reading a new book right now. It's not a new book. It's new to me. It's called Fingerprints of the Gods. And it's actually all about the ancient societies of Central America and Mexico and how fucking advanced those people were. But what this guy brings up in his book is that everybody thinks it was the Maya calendar or whatever, you know, that could go to infinity. Of course, they ended it in like 2012 or whatever. That was like their... Right. End date of this, I forget what they called it now, but anyway, basically the world had ended four times up to their thinking, and we were in the fifth cycle, and the fifth cycle ended in 2012. But in this book, and I'm about halfway through it, and he hadn't really made his point yet, but it's starting to come about, like, I think I know where he's going with this, but not real sure at this point, but he's already proven that basically none of that technology came from those people. It came from people before them. And even they say that in their legends and in their lore, they say they didn't invent the shit. They say they didn't build most of those pyramids. They say that was an ancient technology handed down from them by gods. And they have names for them and everything. The funny thing is, all their gods, it's actually the same god in different places. He's depicted the exact same way. He just goes by different names, like Viracocha down in Peru, and I forget what his name is. I'll remember it for next time. But anyway, different name. But the god and gods of this that were handed down to him were all slender, white men with beards. And it's fucking nutty, like, there weren't any skinny white dudes with beards running around back then. So, but they say they were.
In Northern Africa?
No, it was Central America.
You're talking about the Mayan pyramids.
I'm talking about, starting with the Incas, starting all the way down in Peru with the, in Masca, with the Masca lines and Punapunku and all those places with these insane figures, which, I mean, you can Google all this you want to. Literally, like, if you're standing on the ground, you just see like a bunch of rocks in a row and you don't know what the fuck you're even looking at. Like, it's just like, what is this? You have to literally get in a helicopter and get elevated by a little bit to see that there are huge spiders and snakes and a monkey and all these different figures, dude. Like, these massive, massive, massive outlines. And this shit is lined up like they had a fucking measuring tape and went around and did it. It's insane to even be able to conceive that you could do this and have no aerial perspective at all, which obviously they didn't.
Or did they? Or did they?
They say they didn't do it, and the people that did do it did have error of perspective. Right. They were gods that came down from heaven.
And yeah, and gods could, yeah, dude, there's so much shit that we don't fucking know. I swear to God.
I think, like, to go along with what you were saying, though, if you, you know, by the time we knew them, or by the time the invasion happened, the Spaniards came over here and wrecked their shit. Yes, they had fucking paint on their face and shit all in their head and, you know, piercings and things everywhere. And they still carried on this very crazily good fucking mathematical and aeronautical fucking engineering that, like, I mean, insanely, it's like more accurate. Their shit, like timing the days and the lunar calendar and everything else, was more accurate than the very first Europeans that even came up with the goddamn system. Even more accurate than that. Like 3,000, 5,000 years later, they were more accurate than that.
Yeah.
It's fucking nuts. But again, they say they didn't come up with it. So at some point, we were a very, 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 very fucking advanced civilization. And then we devolved all the way down, right? And then we've obviously come all the way fucking back up.
And how many times has that happened? Like, I mean, it could have been.
They said four, and we were on our fifth cycle. That's, yeah, according to them.
There's a if you really want to, like, get deep into the woods, I won't even say conspiracy theory, although it's a theory. It's a theory. It's crazy, whack physics theory. Eric Weinstein did an interview with Joe Rogan. It was on the Joe Rogan show, and they were talking a lot about kind of these UFO things that are going on. And he's one of the world's most renowned physicists, but he's anti-woke, anti-left. If you listen to him talk for 4 hours, he'll say nerdy shit because he's extremely intelligent, but he speaks a lot of the time in normal jargon and that you can understand. But the first couple hours, they were talking about kind of what they can explain and what they know as of what, you know, what they've seen and what they can kind of figure out for now. The last 2 hours, he went into some fucking wormholes about some of the shit that you're just talking about some of these ancient civilizations, how it would work on the physics spectrums that we know, and how, not necessarily time travel, but yes, time travel, the way he explains it, it's not really time travel.
Well, it's like, not time it's, travel, but possible time travel, but could be,
yeah,
but it isn't.
Well, it's the way
time travel.
And the way he explained it was very, Goodwill Hunting, complicated, but
what's your major?
But
hey,
when he's,
hey Joe, what's your major?
Yeah, his major was, let me tell you, the way you think of time and the way we think of time as a there's dimensions of time, and the only way that we think of time is like an arrow. So like time is always moving forward. It we can't go back, obviously. But he was like, that's one dimension of time. Then there's two, three, four, and then five dimensions. It's like if time is on a spectrum. And you can, you know, a two dimension would be, well, you can go forward or backward. That's two. But what if you can, like, skip and like a CD, like a cassette, like when you're playing a cassette and you're you hit play at the very beginning, it plays all the way through. If you want to go back in time, it's two dimensional. You got to rewind all the way through the entire thing to start at the beginning. So that's two dimension. A record player can, it goes one dimension, then you can drop it at any certain point. So it's different. And then, like, you know, there's some shit out there and there's some theories about people visiting us that it could just be us. And we think it's from like light years away, which it probably is. But the way he explained it is the time it takes to get from here to like the nearest star is like 100,000 years if we travel at the fastest speed that we have capability of right now. But what if time, like, that's if you're thinking of time the way we think of it, one dimensional. What if you have a way to bend time? And these are things that some of the greatest, you know, minds are working on. If you can bend time and change that to where it's not, you're not rewinding a tape or going one dimensional. What if you can warp it and loop it and do all these tricks with time? It's fucking crazy shit, dude. Like,
yeah, that's basically was Einstein's
relative theory. Yeah, it's
but it wasn't the general theory of relativity. It was the special relativity, because it was basically what Einstein did was explain that he debunked Newton's gravity law. And so there was no such thing as gravity. It's just space and time, and they're woven together, and it's called space-time. And anything with enough gravitational pull can bend space-time, like literally bend it around it. Like you can bend time with enough gravitational pull.
Yeah, he talks a lot about that, and a lot about how the next, because Einstein obviously was a pioneer in that and changed the way we view everything. They're gonna have a breakthrough that's gonna change everything again. It's gonna completely change everything. So I highly recommend, if you haven't seen it, the Joe Rogan Show. He did like a 4-hour interview with this dude, because he just keeps going and going. He's got all these, he knows what he's talking about, but he's got these like really high level theories and possibilities that could happen if we have the way, you know, we only see the world through what we can understand and what we know up to that point. But if it changes, it opens up a whole world of things we can't even comprehend. So yeah, it's,
I mean, that's whew. When the Mayans and all that talk about their, the Incas talk about like Viracocha, like they only think that that's a god because that's what they're, first of all, that's what their traditions told them. Mm-hmm. Secondly, if there were people around to meet those people, which apparently there were, and they taught them all this stuff, well, they think they're a god because that they don't know any other way to rationalize it in their brain, except that this person has to be a god because he knows so much, he can do all these things. They said they levitated all those stones in place. They did all like just, you know, basically like magic, did all this shit or whatever.
Yeah.
And then that's actually the reason why the Spanish were able to conquer them so easily, because they showed up and they've spent their whole lives and, you know, a couple of millennia worshiping light-skinned dudes with beards in shiny suits. And then a bunch of light-skinned dudes with beards in shiny suits showed up. And of course, like any other religion, there was always a comeback. There's always a fucking comeback story. There's always a sequel. They're like, hey, you guys made it back. Look what we did, man. We took all the shit you gave us. We fucking made a calendar for like another 2,000. Like, we're killing it, bro. And they're like, like, can we see all the stuff? Yeah, of course you can. Come on up. Come on in the temple. And then they just slaughtered those motherfuckers.
that's the story?
Yeah. That's the true story.
They slaughtered the gods, what they thought were the gods?
No. The gods slaughtered them. The Spanish killed all the Indians.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
Yeah, there's like one story in particular. They brought them into their main fucking temple outside of Mexico City, and they literally killed like 5,000 of them in one swoop.
Wasn't that the
No, I know what you're talking about. I forget the name of this. This book is really fucking... It's a lot of fucking information to take in, so I'm having to go back and kind of try to soak it all up. But yeah, it was crazy, because I always kind of wondered, like, because in school we were taught, oh, well, they never seen a horse before, and they never seen armor before, so they thought they were like magical gods, which made sense, right? Yeah, but now it makes way more fucking sense, because they literally look like the people that they fucking built statues of and been worshiping the whole fucking time. And again, there's always a comeback story. And another cool thing about this, or another crazy thing, I mean, you know the story of the Tower of Babel, obviously, where in the Bible, you know, God sees them building. They're like, oh, let's build a tower to heaven. And God sees them building, and like, man, if they can do this now, there's no end to what they'll be able to accomplish. Let's go down there and mix up their speech and then fucking scatter them across the world. And that's the end of that shit. And that's how the Bible story goes. Well, in their religion, they have a very similar story, except they were building a tower to heaven. It was multiple gods. And they were like, hey, we don't want them having the knowledge that we fucking have. We got to fuck this shit up. So we went down there again, and same exact story. Fucking crushed that shit and scattered them. Mixed up their language. I mean, it's like the same exact story, thousands of years apart, and
there's so much
apart. Like,
yeah, it's either. So, what do you think? Is that either a sign that there is a one true higher power, or is it a sign that we, as a species, have? Not necessarily made up these stories, but we seek out these type of
we definitely have
gods that we need.
I don't think I very seriously doubt we can make this up, because again, like you said, you can only really conceive of what you know. But with all these stories, because it's not just that, it's the flood story. It's like every their god was a light skinned dude with fucking a beard.
They have a flood story also.
Oh yeah. Wow. That's how one of the epochs. That's how one of the epochs ended. Was in the flood. That's how one time. And then they have, and part of that story is only one couple survived up on a hill, and then like a jaguar and a donkey or some shit like that, and they basically went on and repopulated. Like that started the new epoch or whatever.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So I think, and he's not come to the synopsis of his book yet. Again, I'm only about halfway through.
Yeah.
But he's mentioned several times that for this to be a coincidence is literally impossible. So there has to be some sort of primitive, very, very primitive, long time ago shared knowledge that like everybody had the same fucking knowledge of what happened. And then as we get divided, you know, through Pangaea or whatever,
mm-hmm.
The story stayed. They got, you know, turned. I mean, you know how stories go. They fucking.
Yeah, but wasn't the split of Pangaea? Wasn't it before there was?
Oh yeah.
Major community. Oh, I mean, there was no like.
No.
Oh man, that's some weird. God. We're just such a small. We're here for like a fucking.
And we are definitely a species that has amnesia. I mean, yeah. Look at us today. We have fucking internet, TV, anything to record anything possible. This podcast, whatever. And yet, in 2 weeks, we forget how much shit happened. Even if it supports our shit. Like, I mean, there's 1,000 things right now that we could list that, you know, Biden said or whoever said, and we can't think of five.
Come on, man.
Think
about it. I mean, think about it. You got things happening, and you start smelling little girl's hair.
Wait till you see his fucking speech from today. Oh, Jesus.
I mean, they're redundant at this point. I can't.
No, he started talking about some nurse he had named Pam
Pam.
Two N's.
It's a D. There's a D there somewhere.
There is no D. no. He's like, and let me tell you, she did some things that pretty sure she wasn't taught in nurse school.
Oh my god!
And you hear kind of a couple of chuckles, and he's like, "Nah, I'm serious." He's like, "I'm not kidding. I'm
being serious. Not a joke.
He's like, she would whisper to me, and I couldn't really understand what she's saying, but she would bend down real close so she would breathe on me, so I could feel her breathing, get that connection. And then sometimes she'd go back to her house and she'd get her own pillow because that, you know, it was comfortable.
They're gonna have to stop putting him in, like, is he gonna be out there for 6 more years? Can they really do that?
I mean, they don't want to.
Mm.
They definitely don't want to.
That's actually a good transition to one of the stories I wanted to force in here. He doesn't know really what he's doing. He's just going to go along wherever anybody pushes him to. The cunts that are married to these people, Jill Biden, one of the greatest doctors of all time, Fetterman's wife. I've got this written down
that
to do
bitch
a whole.
Is Canadian, by the way. Now,
Fetterman.
No, his wife.
Fetterman's wife is Canadian.
I guess she's fucking ran off to Canada. So.
Yeah, she's partying or she's vacationing in Canada. Meanwhile, her fucking retarded ass, stroke riddled.
Retarded
husband who's had a stroke. They're saying that he's depressed like super depressed. They can't even, he's having trouble communicating, shocker, but they don't, they're having a hard time figuring out if his lack of communication is because of the stroke or just because he's super depressed and he just can't, he just has no will to live life anymore. And this cunt is out there and just taking the family to fucking Canada, running around doing videos and snapping pictures. All this is fucking gross, man. Like, this is a human story. This is beyond. I mean, no need to go sit there next to him. I mean, this is fucking terrible. What's wrong with these? Like the need for power. And don't forget,
oh,
he should have been.
She couldn't. The media trucks were all around her house, and she didn't know what to do. So she just
what the fuck?
The kids
he should have been pulled out. He should have been pulled out when all this happened. If she really cared about his health and his well-being, she would have pulled him out and said, "Honey, you had a stroke. The last thing you need is the stress of, you know, being in front of cameras when you can't speak." And she pushed him and pushed him and pushed him, and
the
you know,
whole world is going to make fun of you.
Uh huh.
They're all going to laugh at you.
Yeah, and then when you get super depressed because everybody's making fun of you and you feel like, I mean, I feel bad for this guy at this point. I feel so bad for him.
I do too, honestly.
And his fucking wife takes off when he's in the fucking hospital?
She, look, you don't know how she was feeling, first
of
all.
Oh, my God.
First of all, I was on my
again.
Period. And secondly, the news trucks were surrounding my house. I didn't know what to do. I just took my family. I was scared for my family, so we went to Canada. Like, at no point in the interview did she ever mention him. Anything about him, his health, nah. She's like, I was scared, and I didn't know what to do.
We don't do cunt bag of the week. That's on my show, but she is definitely the cunt bag
of
the week.
I hope she's a nominee at least. Jesus.
Oh, she's a fucking gold star winner. She's going straight to the cunt
War
corner.
Alert!
Straight to the cunt corner. She's got to put her nose right in the corner, and she's not allowed out for a long time.
Are you gonna do like a big board, like a cunt of the year contest, like for the end?
I might have to. We can do some cunt awards, maybe make a trophy of
I might have to guest star on there so I can help like present or something.
Mm-hmm. Can do that. We can do some end of the year awards. Sure.
If I can be your Vanna White, I'll fucking like reveal the who won the award.
Yeah, you can never can never be Vanna White. That's she is still on that show, by the way.
I know.
She's 80 up there fucking turning these things.
She's 80. And somehow, though, she's not like, she looks a little weird, but she didn't go like full Madonna. She's had a lot of work done. She doesn't get a lot of close-ups, but even when she does, you're like, all right, Vanna, you've, you know, kind of done the thing. It's okay. It doesn't look weird.
Dude, these videos that come out of, you know, like, you know how South Park did the whole N-word thing, and like,
oh yeah,
the igger, and there's only one letter missing.
Yeah,
there's so many of these that pop up on you know, your little social medias, and I know you're not supposed to laugh, but it's really fucking funny. And
no, it wasn't IGGR, it was N blank GGER, and the category was people who annoy you.
I mean, look, you gotta laugh at yourself sometimes. It's fucking funny.
And the answer was nagger.
Of course, nagger. Yes. That's what I was thinking.
He's like, oh, I don't know what you said. 5 seconds, Mr. Marsh. Okay, I like to solve the puzzle.
And I love posting. I love just posting on there and be like, oh, shit, that's pretty fucking funny. And then you'll get, it's not funny at all. Like, oh, I think it's funny. It's a little funny. Kind of funny, right? It's at least a little funny. I mean, if we're not taking yourself seriously, it's a little funny.
It's fucking hilarious what it was. My favorite part of that episode is the rednecks that come around then. It's like, hey, you're that fella that don't take kindly to other people's races. God. We don't take kindly to people that don't take kindly around here.
Sounds like a character straight out of a fucking Tarantino movie.
Oh my God, it was so fucking funny.
By the way, I don't know if you saw, but we got our first heckler on Truth Social.
No, I didn't see.
I posted our last video from last week, and some fat ass wearing a Trump shirt was like, yeah, you're not funny and you're fat. which cracked me up. And of course, I like, you know, I went back and forth with him for a little bit. I was like, oh, that's cool, man. Like, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. And if you don't think we're funny, you know, you could always come on and like, you know, show us how it's done.
Spice it up, baby.
And of course, he was like, no, there's too many fat people on that show already. I don't want to go. I was fucking dying laughing. I was like, all right, fatty, whatever. But yeah. It's, you know.
Hey man, I'm glad we got a hater. That's awesome.
I don't, it doesn't bother me at all. Like, I mean, people can respond, they can say we suck, they can say we're okay, we're good, whatever you, it doesn't matter. Just
as long as you're watching, baby. As long as you're watching.
I do not give two shits. But I didn't know if you saw it or not. You didn't respond, so I kept responding, and he actually sent me a, because they have a new on Truth, they just got the ability to do direct messaging about, I don't know, but maybe about a month ago. And he came at me on directly, and I was like, dude, come on, just come on the show, man. It'll be fun. We'll chop it up. You can be funny. We'll try to not, you know, suck as bad as you think we do. And he was just like, listen,
that's
man,
tall order, sir. That is tall.
He was like, from one fat slob to another, you know, just, you don't need any more fat. I was like, at one point I was like, does he have a weird lens? Like, I mean, I know we might not be, we're not like, I'm not claiming to be like an Adonis or anything, but I mean, I see his picture and I look at our pictures and but you know, whatever. It's we welcome them all of them. Bring it on.
Yeah, man. Just, hey, come party and have a good time. You disagree? Come disagree with us. It's all good. We're fucking, you know, we're not jerks.
Mm-mm. Well, you know, except for the trannies. The trannies,
they're not going to come on the show.
Or the trendy defenders, who
did
you see
the fucking dude that smoked those bitches in that 1500 over in England? Yeah.
Good.
He kicked their asses.
Good. Enjoy.
It's some fucking, you know, whatever liberal account's like, this is such a beautiful thing. And it's like, it posted like the dude standing next to one of the other racers, a chick, like hugging her. He's like, I defy you to tell the cis woman from the transgender woman. And I was like, the one that looks like a dude is a dude.
It's usually not that hard.
The one with the massive shoulders, the fucking thighs bigger around than her goddamn waist, and the Adam's apple. I'm going to go with that guy for 500, Alex, please.
Yeah, it's usually really simple. And I know that there's like, there's these like model trannies that you know, can trick you. And, you know, good for them. There's some really good.
They don't play sports.
No, they don't play sports. But they are playing with fire if they try to get in a relationship with a dude and they haven't taken care of old Johnny downstairs.
Big old Mr. Knish.
Because, you know, that's let's just say that people aren't going to respond nicely to that.
You remember the tranny that Mac was dating, the fucking hot-ass chick from Joe
well,
Dirt?
The fake tranny, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, she's not obviously a tranny or whatever, but she was playing one on there. Yeah, she. I mean, if that was real, she could fool me for sure. She's
of course, and I've seen pictures of these trannies that have really transformed themselves, and they are hard to tell. But it really doesn't matter. That's not even really the point. The point is the athletes that play against the women, they're gonna have a huge advantage. It doesn't matter how much you can deceive someone on the surface.
Beat them bitches.
It doesn't change what you are as a human. So I don't know. We have to bring it up. It's one of the rules. We have to talk about trannies every show. So I thought I'd slide that in there.
Well, I want to end with this. We're running out of time here. I'm actually very disappointed with you. I got a bone to pick. You're my politic guy, right? You're my source.
I like big butts and small government. Says it right there. Sure enough.
So you always bring up these fucking chicks in the government that, you know, that are, I mean, you bring them, I know that they're government hot or whatever. Like, they're not, like, you saw them on the street, like, meh. But, you know, for the government, whatever, Boebert.
What's up, Boebert? Call me.
But yet, you've never brought to my attention, I'm looking at her picture right now, Miss Anna Paulina. Never.
Let's just Google.
She is fucking gorgeous. I mean, it's absolute smoke show.
Anna. Oh, is this? Oh, the Luna?
Yeah, and she's got like bikini pics and everything else.
Is this the one that, is she from Texas? Is this the one that won down there on the border?
I believe so.
Yeah. I've seen her before. I think, yeah. I haven't
never
talked,
brought her up, and she's
no,
by a million miles the hottest person in all of our elected, in all of our elected government.
She is good. That is some good. Actually, I don't think that's her. The one I'm thinking about.
Yeah, I don't know if that's her or not either, but either way,
my God. Yeah, we've got a new one. Hello. Hello, Anna Paulina Luna. Good
Lord. Did you find the bikini pic where she's got her top straps down?
No, but I'm going to do some real hard research later when I have more time. I really just want to see where she's from. Like, what district is she in? Fuck.
She needs to fucking represent my district. I know that.
Is it Florida? It looks like she's in Florida.
She's fuck, got a I don't great know. Tan. I don't know.
Anyways, yes. No, this one's new to me. I don't, you know, there are.
AOC has been replaced as the official hottest Latina in all of.
Hey, yo, big booty Latina. Anna Paulina Luna, big booty Latina. What's up, girl? Oh, my God. Yeah, there's like 400. What's the count? 435 representatives in the country. And they have a vote.
Many.
They have a vote every 2 years. As much as I would love to keep up with every single one of them, sometimes they fall through the cracks. But yeah, is she Republican?
I don't give a.
She's fuck. Holding guns in front of American flag. She's absolutely fucking Republican. I know that so far. I'll do like I said more.
I wish she was for the other side posing like that. That'd be that's fucking true. Great.
God, she's holding fucking two ARs in front of American flag. Holy shit!
I saw that picture.
Good. God almighty, yeah. Let's get her on, you know what? I'm going to send her an email, see if we can get her on this show.
Hey, she's an elected public servant. She has a public duty to come on this show and keep us abreast of the issues.
Newly elected Florida Republican. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she, oh my God.
Oh, DeSantis 2024, baby. This is what
there's your VP. There's your fucking VP right there.
Hey, guys, we know she just showed up an hour ago, but look at those tits.
Yeah. I mean, she can't speak any worse than Kamala. I mean, even if she's – have you heard her speak yet? Have you heard – yeah.
I just found out she existed like an hour ago.
So can she be any worse than the one we have? No. So anything would be a step up on that. And, oh, yeah. Lauren Boebert, scoot on over. Good Lord. Is she married? Yeah, whatever. We don't have time for this. Let's. What else, you guys? Is that it?
Well, I expect a full report back on our new official girl of the Bastards of Babylon, Miss Anna Paulina.
I'll have several pages of her. Hopefully they won't be stuck together and I can read the full,
Wait till you get the fucking picture of her on the beach in the bikini. And she's got this white, and she's like holding the straps like this and just like holding them up.
I want to do a quick tease to next week. Next week, we will have a interview. Fingers crossed. It's not, you know, in concrete yet, but we will have a OnlyFans model interview. Not sure exactly where we're going to go with this. Not sure exactly what we're going to talk about.
Is it Representative Paulina?
It's, oh man, it is not her, but I have been told that there are no topics off limit. We can ask any questions we want. So in between our stupid fat, apparently fat by some, one of our hecklers' faces, you will see a OnlyFans model, and we'll see what her story is. See what we got there.
Well, boys and girls, if that's not a reason to tune in next week, I don't know what is. All right. Well, guys, that was it. So subscribe to the Revolution Network. You get this show, The Bastards of Babylon, Football and Freedom, my boy Longhorn. I Mean It show of me, and then FGH coming at you with some draft shit. The rumor's getting hot, heavy, and coming in a hurry, baby. Kind of like my buddy Longhorn as soon as Paulina shows up. But anyway.
Luna.
All right, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.